So, Nicolas, Kat and I were very lucky to see the movie a few days ago. Very early in the morning, I have to say. So we went at 9:30.
Oh, wow.
Okay. And I don't like watching trailers. I don't like watching anything. So I had no idea what I was going to watch at 9:30 in the morning.
It's an assault at 9:30 in the morning.
It was an assault.
I feel like I don't really watch films in the morning generally anyway. So maybe I'll start watching movies at 9:30 just to see how they make me feel.
Yeah, it did set us up in like, I mean, we walked in smelling like coffee and we walked out like that. Like literally so like, oh my God, that was just insane. Like, I couldn't wait to tell my family.
Yeah.
My family are going to love it. Everyone's going to love it.
It's quite a wild ride, and I think it feels quite original and different to most things.
Yeah, and it's fast. It's like a fast-paced movie.
It's an hour and a half.
Yeah.
And it keeps moving.
It keeps moving. The music's incredible and just...
And also, it's different seeing you in this role as well. We've not seen you in a role like this before, right?
I don't think so, no. I play Renfield, who is Dracula's assistant, his familiar, who's been working for him for 100 years and is quite run down by working for him. He's a bit of a narcissistic, gaslighting, horrible boss. And so he wants to get help to get out of this toxic relationship, and he ends up in like a self-help group for codependents, and then meets Awkwafina's character, who's a cop, and she stands up to this local crime family, and then he gets inspired to be like, oh, okay, maybe I can escape this toxic relationship myself. And so that's the kind of central premise of the movie.
I like the modern twist on it too, like the self-help groups. And like, it was good. It was really like, you know, the old Dracula meeting the new superhero feel to it as well. Like,
yeah, the core concept and idea I felt was very original.
Yeah.
Like, oh, let's look at those relationships through this guise of like the worst boss imaginable.
There was a bit of tongue-in-cheek as well moments that you just go, oh my God, that was actually really funny, but yet really full on at the same time.
Yes.
You know, well, those sort of
like
moments.
A horror action comedy, I suppose. And I think that's, I love that. And that's the most fun thing to experience, I think, in a cinema, is when you get to like laugh with people and also be shocked and be grossed out and then also be like, what is happening with this film?
I mean, you'll definitely have people looking through their fingers in a couple of scenes, because we did, because I was like, oh my goodness. But
we did love it. What was it like working with Nicolas Cage?
Oh, I had the best time with it. I did a movie with him when I was 14 called The Weatherman. I played his son in that movie.
Oh, wow.
And so we haven't seen or worked with each other since.
Yeah.
And it was amazing to be back with him, because now as an adult, I'm obviously also just better versed in cinema.
Yeah.
So I've seen so much more of his work and so many of his iconic performances. So to get to then watch Nick Cage inhabit the role of Dracula in front of me, I think he's clearly having so much fun as this character and channeling so many wonderful things that it's a real hoot.
What's Nicolas sort of like though, off like filming and like hanging out? Is he method?
No, he's not method. And there's been a bit of clickbait stuff come out in press where it's like, oh, Nick Cage shaved his teeth down to play Dracula, stayed in character.
His teeth are amazing in it, by the way.
He has incredible teeth, but they are false. Yeah. I didn't shave his teeth into that shape.
I mean, veneers though, if you get veneers, it's not dissimilar, is it?
I couldn't stop staring at his teeth the whole time. Veneers.
Yeah, yeah. He would, you know what he would do? He would go home and he would practice talking in those teeth in his hotel, because obviously they were kind of like almost like a denture that would hook over his teeth.
Yeah.
And so he had to practice so he could pronounce everything as he saw kind of correct for Dracula, I suppose. So he would practice at home, but there was no method on set.
I mean, he's very funny in it as well. Like, were there any scenes where you're like, because I feel like as well that he might have done a bit of like, you know, improvising when it was happening.
Did he
like try and surprise you?
There was this scene where I come back to my apartment, I've tried to escape him, and then he's turned up at my apartment to surprise me. And he saw Anne Bancroft's role in The Graduate as kind of inspiration.
Oh, wow.
So he kind of took this moment in that element. I've just walked in with a new outfit, and he said, oh, you look like the sort of boy who has to fight them off or something. And he was like coming up with these ideas of having like blood martinis with eyeballs in them and stuff. So yeah, he brought a lot of great ideas.
You've worked with so many greats. Is there anyone else that you would love to work with in the industry?
Ooh, Javier Bardem.
Oh, yes, that would be great. What kind of role could you see for you two?
I don't know, but I love No Country for Old Men. I think he was brilliant in that.
Anything with him.
Yeah, I think he's a great actor.
And so there's been rumors, so correct me if I'm wrong, that you could be the next 007.
Oh, no, I don't think so.
Oh, really?
It was a rumour that we made up while we were in the cinema. So, leant over and I was like, 007?
And then I thought, you know, with your action moves as well, and, you know, it was pretty, like, impressive. And I thought, that's so Bond.
Well, Renfield's not really, like, trained to be, like, an assassin. He's more someone who, like,
strong.
Yeah, he has these powers after he eats bugs, but he doesn't want to use violence and he doesn't really want to hurt people, but he's just kind of a means to an end.
He doesn't want to hurt
people.
But
I could so see you doing Bond.
I don't know. You know what? I'm friends with Aaron Taylor Johnson and he's like rumoured, potentially.
Should we start a rumour as well?
And like, I think he would be great.
Yes.
So... That would be my show.
Well, I think you would be pretty good as well.
Maybe
to
I
be
could
fair.
Be the assistant to Bond.
Dude, by the way, did you eat those bugs? Were they real in real life? Were they real bugs?
They were real bugs. You know,
real bugs.
The props department were amazing. They made like caramel cockroaches and things that were delicious. Mm-hmm. But the crickets were real crickets that were like dried out and flavored. To be fair, so they were like salt and vinegar crickets or barbecue crickets.
That's supposed to be good for you, huh?
Yeah. Well, that's what. You know, they say that if everyone can get over their fear of eating bugs, they're high protein, low in fat, and we could solve world hunger right now.
Delicious.
If we bugs. So
stick to crisps.
Would you do the jungle in that case?
Well, those are kind of what are the big like
big caterpillar, kind of
witchetty grubs.
Yeah. Right? Those and eyeballs and stuff.
You'd be so strong if you ate that.
I don't want to be getting on that stuff.
Imagine how much strength you'd have.
It's the bursting, isn't it, of those things?
Yes,
sorry, it's too early.
The pop and the goo.
The pop and the goo, which I don't need. Like,
just a nice little crispy cricket. Yeah, that's fine.
Lovely. Although they do get a little bit bitty in your teeth. Like you find the odd little limb or wing.
Enjoy your breakfast, everyone, while you're listening to Magic Breakfast Show.
Oh, I love it. I love it.
We have got a little surprise for you. Someone who works here at Magic.
Yeah.
Now, they claim to have gone to school with you.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. This, you look terrified. I'm so sorry.
I'm like,
Let's see if we can bring him into the studio.
Yes.
See if you can remember him.
Oh, my gosh.
Dude.
How are you? Oh, how sweet. It's a reunion.
It's a friendly one. Do you guys like hang out at school?
Yeah, we were in the basketball team together.
Oh, nice.
We did GCSE drama together, and as you can tell,
you guys played basketball together.
Well, Nicholas played basketball. I very much sat on the bench.
Right.
Okay. Well, that's kind of playing. That's how I play.
English standards of basketball aren't that high. But at Ranelagh, we did play.
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
So, yeah.
See, we thought he was telling porky pies, but, you know.
No. We went to school together. Amazing.
There you go.
How have you been since then? I haven't seen you in 15 years.
Yeah, all good.
Are you still living out? Are you in London now?
Yes, yeah. Right. Yeah, I've been Walthamstow way. So,
amazing. Yeah. So, have you seen any of the school?
No, not in not a long time. You will really? Be, yeah, probably one of the first people I've seen.
Really?
Since leaving, yeah.
Oh, amazing. You should have you should start a proper reunion for everyone, right?
Sure.
Facebook. Definitely. I love it. Well, I'm glad we could make that happen.
Yes.
That was a nice surprise. Nice. When people say surprise, I'm like, I get worried about it.
I wanted to say to you, it's okay, it's fine, don't worry. No, it's not a bad surprise. Good.
Oh, that's very sweet.
It's James Green, everyone. Thank you, James.